Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Neymar, and this time out, we are watching the final two episodes of Power Rangers Dino Fury, The Truth and The Nemesis. So without any further ado, we're going to jump into our first episode, which we are going to start here in 3, 2, 1, go.
Previously on Power Rangers.
I'm Oria. We're Refconians like you.
No freaking way.
Rise. Yes, freaking way.
Patch.
Now you'll remember.
This is Boy Queen.
This is going to tell us this, but Amelia learned something pretty important about herself.
Tell you, I'm not your parents. Aliens. They had a baby. It was you.
What do you mean, Pop?
Now, you may have already been spoiled by this on Twitter, but if you haven't, this is awesome.
He's getting worse. Please, you have to remember something. Who are my parents? Where are they from?
All Area 62 personnel evacuate. I repeat, all personnel evacuate.
Help us, please. We're trapped in here. The smoke. Too much. Come on. Please. Please help us.
I'm just a janitor. But you gotta get out of there. They say the whole place is gonna blow.
The hole's too small for us.
What? Please.
Whoever. Whoever that is acting as the younger Pop-Pop is doing a very good job.
If we don't make it out in time, promise you'll keep us safe.
Me? But I...
Promise!
Of course, I promise.
Go! Get out of here!
Those voices sound not very familiar. She's wearing pink.
I think I just...
How did she see that from the third person, though?
I feel strange.
Oh, dude! I knew it!
Like Dip.
You know the irony of this? Is that,
Guys?
Oh.
I think my parents were from RAFCON.
A cold open! That's cool! I didn't even realize it. The Truth was the 21st episode of Power Rangers Dino Fury Season 2. It was written by Alwyn Dale and Becca Barnes and directed by Simon Bennett. The irony,
like,
anyway,
inside his mind, seeing everything,
is that when they switched bodies,
wham,
she was trying to get Zato's antenna
sometimes
to pop up, and she couldn't.
Situations. Otherwise, it takes a lot of training. I got mine pretty late, and all the kids teased me.
All the time I was searching for my people, and here you are.
It's crazy.
Excuse me.
Is there anything else you remember? Where did they come from? What did they look like?
Sorry, my memory's not that hot, but there would have been files in the facility. Oh, yeah. I think they kept them in a safe. If anything survived that blast,
files might still exist.
Oh, boy.
An emergency live stream.
Buzz Blasters, Mayor Jemison has issued an evacuation order for all of Pine Ridge. With multiple sporic beast attacks across the city, now turn card over.
Not turn card over.
Viewers to stay calm. The Rangers and their alien allies are doing their best to protect us.
Speaking of, we need to get back into the fight.
can't let Ori have all the fun.
You gotta lie down, okay, Pop-Pop? We need to get you better.
Excuse me, and okay, that sounds good.
I'll keep an eye on him. Now go, stop the Sporix.
He seems to be handling the dinosaur lady pretty well.
The eastern highway to Coral Harbor is bumper to bumper, so look for alternative evacuation routes.
Forget the plant, Stan!
Please, Mr. Leafy, I would never...
And as always,
okay.
Sporix, call the Ranger hotline on...
555-0172, the Rangers will come.
Ooh, fancy!
Oh, they turned the thing off too soon.
No, my queen has her own announcement.
Good luck, Mr. Leafy.
Bye, Mr. Leafy. Well, the guy with the microphone's gone.
Action.
Hello. Or should I say goodbye? Hope you've been enjoying my revenge, because every moment my brave beasties grow stronger with destructive power. Which I will use to end all of you.
Oh.
Now, my Sporix, it is time.
Oh, what is she doing?
She does her own stunts and her own special effects. That thing needs a close-up.
Is that a cocoon? Is Trakina coming back? Again? Oh, they never do that.
That's new.
Yeah, they don't stop coming.
Warriors, keep the beasts busy.
Come on, they flew this way. Whoa, that's, different.
Yeah.
Ollie, you usually have a theory. What is that thing?
Tactically, you mean hypothesis and a... no idea.
Trouble is what that thing is. Because Void Queen's cooking up into something really... Actually, she never told us what it was. But I bet it's something really nasty. Because she's the best mom ever!
Oh, she just became part of it.
Oh, Void Queen's in there? Let's finish her!
Whoa, hold up! Be careful! That glowing blob thing just destroyed Mucus!
Indestructible Mucus?
We've never seen that much power before.
Any way we can figure out what she's doing in there? If anyone's got the gear to find out, it's my mom.
Solon, call Dr. Akana. We're gonna need her back from Japan.
What do you think it is, Doctor?
Spontaneous matter creation from the Sporix energy. That explains the readings.
For once, this is data I don't like.
Sheesh. It's absorbing Sporix and the energy at a rate so high, it's definitely gonna explode.
So, how frightened should we be? Ask for a friend.
Oh, there's no need for your friend to worry. If we can evacuate the city and boost the base's shields to max, we'll be safe here. And the destruction when that cocoon hatches will be limited to property damage, landscaping, and forestry.
What do you mean, okay. Landscaping and forestry,
Please, Pop-Pop, you need to rest, but... yeah, what does that mean?
Everything in a 30-mile radius will be vaporized.
Oh! Not good.
Kinda sorry I asked.
It might not come to that. There's gotta be an hour or so before the energy becomes too unstable for the cocoon to hold. Can we try to move it? Or maybe pop it like a balloon so it deflates and it goes... My bad.
Sorry, Javi, it's too risky. The slightest movement could set it off.
Lonnie and I will investigate all options. There may be a way to stop it, or at least slow it down. What now?
So Dad should expand the evac radius to 30 miles.
Better let Oria know, too.
And Wreckmate has gone giant downtown.
Izzy, Ion, make those calls. Pop-Pop, get to the sick bay, okay?
Area 62, last chance for answers.
Amelia, I'm not doing too good. Please, don't leave me!
We'll deal with Wreckmate. Stay with Pop-Pop. Join us when you can.
Oh. Thanks. Aww.
Good luck.
A little kiss.
Get you back to bed.
Solon, let's deploy the Zords.
Okay. Link to Morgan.
He faked it. Totally faked it.
Okay. Wait, were you faking just then?
If you want answers about your parents, you need to get to Area 62 before it's destroyed. There's a safe I passed every day on my mopping rounds. Just before I go and have my little muffin break. Go and find it. That place is radioactive, so take my suit. Stay safe.
Oh, the suit they they introduced way back. The beginning of this part of the season.
Thanks, Pop-Pop.
So cool. I love the setup. It's funny because since the series has been posted, Simon has been saying things have been sprinkled throughout, and they have. And there she is at the. Is that the gun? That's her ghost gun.
0.1? Barely any radiation. Here goes nothing. Okay,
that's only where all the bad guys are.
Huh. That's a freebie. Still okay. Now, if I was a safe, where would I be?
Okay, we've never seen this part of Area 62
or
before.
Some kind of cover-up.
Amelia Jones.
Who's there?
You're trespassing.
Gordon Garcia? Sorry, I know I'm not supposed to... Hold on. Aren't you supposed to be evacuating the city?
Oh, I am. I'm just on a coffee break.
That's not the word.
Without coffee. Forget this.
Oh, and her morphers in damaged?
And now I'll make you pay for sneaking into our base.
Hold on. Area 62 is your base?
You didn't know? Whoops. Oh well, without your morpher, you can't tell a soul.
Oh boy.
How about we combine these puppies?
Just what I was thinking. Time for two of my favorite words. Zords combine.
I cannot believe that it's going to take this episode to finally get rid of this guy.
Mega Fury Saber! Let's sink this ship!
Primal Ultra Blast!
Oh, no! I'm wrecked!
That's one more Sporex for the cocoon!
Get it!
And no more power.
Grab it!
What's up, Solon?
Bad news. I got an alert. Amelia's comm is being destroyed. She's not with Pop-Pop. I've looked everywhere. She's gone.
Gone? Why would she?
I know where she is.
Look at her go!
Round two! Ding, ding!
I love it.
It's your final curtain call.
Back off. This show isn't over. So glad you're okay.
You guys found me.
Pop-Pop told us about his little performance earlier.
Well, it's okay. We talked to him. We totally get why you came here.
A new morpher. Easier to replace than you, so maybe tell us next time.
Thanks, guys. You're the best.
If your friends can crash this party, then so can mine. Henchmen! Lights! Camera! Attack!
Make the morphing grid!
Oh, that is so awesome. That might have been a callback to the very first episode.
Excuse Dino Nike.
In the very first episode, she was already morphed, but she had a backflip just like that.
I bet you haven't rehearsed for this.
Step away. Kinda.
Any final lines?
Only one. Exit.
Exit. Nice.
Dino Dagger. Duck.
Well, that was cool.
Easy.
Yeah, that was sweet.
What if I hadn't dubbed?
It's not worth losing your head over.
Ah ha ha.
Good?
Whew, thanks for the save. Didn't realize I was walking into an evil lair.
Fair point. Now, the signage isn't exactly clear.
We should look around and see if we can find anything to stop that cocoon. We'll help look for the safe, too.
Thanks. Come on.
And if they're morphed, they're probably good for the, uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Easy does it. There could be anything in here.
Like, oh, they're in the main room!
Lots of junk.
Now this looks like an evil base.
If I can find the system interface, I'll see if there's any useful data here.
And the rest of us can look for anything else that's useful.
You think,
they'll find the secret room?
Build Slyther and Wreckmate?
Ew. Mucus has definitely been here.
Hang on. Is this?
It's the safe!
Oh man! I think I found the safe from Pop Pop's memories!
Go on, open it!
Here it goes. Huh? It's empty.
I'm sorry, Amelia. That really sucks.
There goes my last chance to get any solid info. Wait, what?
Oh, that's not fair.
This may come as a shock, but you're not the only one who can use this thing.
Dude!
You entered my home uninvited. And now, you'll never leave.
Get away from them!
Oh! Cool.
We only came to Earth to scavenge.
Our people need supplies for their ships. We've got to get it all home to them.
I'm afraid this facility is your home now.
They're Rafconian too?
Hush, little one.
They're her parents. So that means when the wish thing happened, she did see her parents, because I believe she did see Void Knight or Void King and Queen. So, wow.
We'll make it out in time. Promise you'll keep her safe.
Me, but I
promise.
Of course, I promise.
Go! Get out of here!
Oh, she got hit on the head.
Oh, baby. Did she?
They couldn't have
survive that.
No one could. Oh, no. They think she died.
They must pay.
That's how he came up with... Oh, look at that. It all ties together.
You saw my memories. I saw yours. My child. The explosion. You were lost. But you were here. All along.
Pop kept his promise. And loved me like I was his own, but... I've spent my entire life searching for my parents.
You found us.
Oh! The same thing happened to Javi and Izzy.
All the hate. The anger. It's gone. I feel like myself.
About to blow. I've got Pop and Dr. Arcana to safety, but the city's gridlocked. There's no way they'll be evacuated in time.
That's a cliffhanger, folks. Okay, so, mind blown. I think we called this, though. This has been called... I mean, it's nice to have confirmation, but we kind of called this way back. This was a big theory. That the two of them were... that she was from... Rafcon. We kind of knew that. Clues were there. And the parent thing was also kind of there. Although they never specifically said that they were Rafconian. So it's nice to see that that actually happened. And then to have it all come true is awesome. And oh boy, this is going to be interesting. So I wonder, will he be turning him back into Void Knight again, you think? I guess we'll find out. So let's jump into our final episode. And we are going to do that in 3, 2, 1, go. Are we gonna have a previously? No, we're not. The Nemesis was the 22nd and final episode of Power Rangers Dino Fury. It was written by Becca Barnes and Alwyn Dale and directed by Simon Bennett. Oh, we do get it previously, but just afterwards.
They had a baby. It was you.
Here goes nothing. Get away from them! Please, take our child to safety.
Promise you'll keep her safe.
I've spent my entire life searching for my parents.
You found us.
Oh, I was gonna say, no way.
After the explosion that you really need to worry about. The cocoon is going to hatch.
Our data didn't show that.
Wait. Hatch into what?
Guessing the answer is not cute baby birds.
I don't know exactly.
No.
Something with the power of all the sporks combined.
Tarek, do you know any way to stop Void Queen?
No. I wish I did. She's full of hate because she lost you. She has no idea her daughter is someone she's trying to destroy.
Hold on. If learning the truth about me fixed you, do you think that could work on her?
It might be our only hope.
It's a chance!
You and your warriors need to evacuate.
Good luck, Rangers.
Let's go.
No argument. Just, all right, we're off.
Bigger and more juiced up. You tried unplugging it?
Void Queen is totally wrapped in Sporix. Even if we get close, you won't be able to link minds with her. We'll have to get her out of that thing.
Hold on. It's unstable. And if we mess with it, it could hatch even quicker. Either way, it'll explode. And the city isn't empty yet. Is there a way to move it?
Maybe if I was in Dino Knight armor, it might protect me. I could teleport the cocoon out to the desert.
That might be far enough.
It's dangerous, but as the leader of this team, I've got to do this.
No, you don't. This is my fault. Give me the Dino Knight warp.
Void Knight.
I can become Void Knight one last time and do the job.
I don't think
Zeta, that's... You and your team are still needed for what will be the biggest battle of your lives. Let me do this for you.
Be quick.
Okay. We don't have much time.
Been a while. Bet you never thought you'd see Amelia hugging Void Knight, right?
Now stay back.
Sense. Do you think Terra could have survived that?
We have to get out there.
I hope now. So.
Link to Morphin.
It's the final episode. They wouldn't kill him. I mean, Pop-Pop's okay.
Terrick? Terrick!
Oh, it's so much for the Dino Knight Morpher.
Are you okay?
Yes. There are bigger problems.
Whoa.
They didn't notice?
Oh, okay, cool.
Okay, cool.
So this thing is very clean.
One more time.
I can't say I like the makeover.
That's not her. It's all the sporks combined, which means
she's still inside.
Behold, the Nemesis Beast.
Oh boy. Notice the bones and ribs and muscle.
You don't have to do this. I know who you really are. You're my mom.
Don't play games with me!
She won't listen or believe you! That's why we've got to get her out of that thing!
It's big, but we've taken down bigger, right?
Can we get a fact check on that?
Not really.
Solon, we need all our Zords, ASAP!
Enough talking!
Are the controls bones?
I was wrong about you. Did great. Now get to safety. Good luck, Rangers.
We got this. Flee, traitor. It's all you're good at.
All right. Swords are back.
Just in time. Glad you're here. This time, we need every single one of you.
Oh, they're all there. How does this work? Ah, okay.
Link,
the Cosmic Megazord!
Ready, team?
Ready!
You'll regret testing me!
Oh man, I hope the Zords survive this. They're kind of living, aren't they? Wow, look at that.
This thing is tougher than one of Dad's steaks.
We gotta play to our strengths.
Ollie and I will create an opening.
Did that really work?
Your turn!
Team Garcia has entered the chat.
Ooh!
Leaving the chat.
Nice!
Oh yeah!
Ooh, nice save!
You guys okay?
Yeah. Incredible move.
Time for another one. Let's high jump.
Freeze strike!
Nah, it doesn't seem to have done anything.
That's not good. Brace! Brace!
Oh, they're all trashed. Not trashed, but they all broke apart.
We're out of options. There's only one thing left. Dino Master Saber!
Oh, no.
This is it.
You can't use the ultimate attack! You know what the Green Morphin Master said!
Even if it destroys me, I have to stop her!
Oh no!
Uh-oh.
It's okay. I can do this. Let me do this!
New plan! If I can reach her, I can show her the truth. Who wants to see something wild?
It's about to get wild! Oh, look at this!
She's seen us! Too slow!
Oh, this is cool! He's riding a henchman. Nice. Oh yeah, this is their morphing poses. Gosh.
And now it ends for the rest of you.
Void Queen!
Duh.
This is the end. Just not for them.
Uh-oh.
Master Saber, energize!
Oh no, he's gonna do it! All the Zords are going into the Saber. Oh no. gosh. It's breaking the saber. Where's Amelia? Did anyone see her land?
How did you do this? Who's been spilling my secrets?
I have. And you need to listen. We're trying to help you, Santora.
Santora? That name means nothing to me. Just like you mean nothing. Traitor!
But it's true.
Please tell me.
I don't care. My victory is secure.
She's alive.
My sporics are safe, and the Earth's suffering will be remembered forever. Remember this.
Ah, finally.
When Amelia was a baby, her parents were lost.
This water contains everything I know about what happened to them. Pop Pop doesn't like to talk about it. He says they were lost in the fire, but no details.
I wish I could see my parents, even just for a moment.
Ah, see?
All the hate, the anger, it's gone.
But my revenge, I...
She used it to destroy the monster. Nice.
The sports. I was wrong. I was so wrong.
Awesome.
What? I'm you're
wearing pink. Maybe it is purple. Pinkish purple.
I never stopped looking for you.
Aww. Uh-oh. Only three of them?
The Morphin Masters!
We felt a surge in the grid and came as quickly as we could.
Well, it took you a while.
The Master Saber has vanquished the Sporix.
Well done. With their power drained, we can safely seal them away. Your mission is complete, Rangers.
No! Not without Zato! You saved him before.
Please! He sacrificed himself for us!
And the whole planet.
We know your leader meant a lot to you. Zato truly was a great ranger.
He's not here.
Was.
But he's not gone. He lives in your hearts, your memories, and in the grid.
What does that even mean?
He's all around you. Everywhere the grid touches, a piece of Zato remains.
What is that?
Miss you, Zato.
Oh, man. And they actually look like they're crying.
And secure them, so they may never escape again.
Goodbye, Rangers. It's been an honor.
I've missed so much.
Yeah, and you killed their friend.
So much to tell you.
Oh. no. Mucus is still alive.
We'll stack all this in the storage area for now.
I'm gonna knock out that there wall. See?
Oh, nice. That'll solve our space problems in the kitchen hall.
And it'll have excellent feng shui. Nice job, Pop-Pop. The Rafconians are gonna love living here.
Any other requests?
Yeah, some help on a decision over here. I like Briarwood Green for your sister's crib.
But honey, Corinthian sunset is so much warmer.
No, I bet it.
So weird.
Ocean bluff blue is a color babies love.
What? No, I'm right. I think I know how to settle this. May I?
Yeah.
Sorry, she seems to like Briarwood Green better.
Yes. Can't argue with that.
Gotta admit, she's a smart cookie.
Yikes! We're running late for something. Sorry.
Happy decorating.
Local sprint legend Izzy Garcia has done it again, breaking the 200-meter sprint record. Her supporters could not be prouder.
That is classic, Dad.
And Ion's got a cafe!
Says the trophy's his third kid, calls it Carlos Jr.
It looks like I really missed out.
Sorry we're late. Happy graduation, Izzy!
Love this academic look on you.
Don't be fooled, it's all athletic wear under that thing.
Hey, have to give up my training. Oakdale Athletics Department, here I come.
Aw, she's gonna go to Oakdale.
You ordered, and some protective gear. Here you go.
Oh, alien cuisine from a real alien.
We can't wait to try them. We're thinking of ordering a giant one to celebrate the opening of Buzz Blast Angel Grove.
Sounds really?
Messy. I'm in. Enjoy. And some smoothies for you guys.
Oh, thank you.
I like the bibs.
Hey, isn't that? I'll be right back.
Who is this? Oh, look. Slyther and Mucus survived.
Javi? Javi Garcia.
Yeah.
I love all your videos. You're so cool, man.
Thanks.
Sign my guitar?
Signatures are $5, but 15 gets you a t-shirt.
She's just kidding.
That's actually really cheap. Okay, so they're not publicly known to be Rangers.
What's up, Solon?
There's an extreme energy fluctuation at Dino Hinge. Something is pushing through the base's force field. Come quick.
On our way.
Cheers.
So
cheers.
Is he the boss now?
Yeah. 3, 2,
no.
1.
I thought the humans didn't like Flargon.
It's right over there.
Maybe they changed it.
That's a ghost. Ollie, everyone, you're seeing this, right?
Uh-huh. Of course.
They're like, no way.
History books, here I come.
Oh, snap.
Sorry, but I'm no ghost.
Oh, his voice is modulated.
Who are you?
Saito's back! How?
Forget the ghost. This is so much better. How are you here?
The Morphin Masters are giving me new powers.
So they brought your energy back from the grid. Did they explain how?
No.
Did they ever?
There's no time. I have an important mission for the team. We have to leave right now.
Ooh.
What's going on? It's Lord Zed. He's escaped.
Link to Morphin Grid!
See that thing on his... Oh, smooth! Nice!
Go get him!
That's the thing he said for their first morph. And that little badge holding together the shoulder pads was like the belt buckle he wore in the first episode, so that was cool. Now, apparently, this ending is not something new. They actually had this as the plan. This was the original plan when they filmed it. They had no idea about Cosmic Fury yet. They were just kind of hoping. Thank goodness that it worked out. So I guess Lord Zedd will be the villain for Cosmic Fury. That'll be cool. Wow, that was awesome. Okay, I am very happy with the way this turned out. I am talking really loud, too. I don't need to be. Anyway, I don't know what to say at this point. That's a lot to take in. I might come back and add something at the end here once I've had a chance to process the season. Hi, everybody. Later me back to talk about my thoughts now that I've had a chance to actually put them together. I really like this series. I think I've made that pretty clear in my coverage of the show and all the commentaries. I found it to be really fun, but also could be pull off the serious stuff really well and let the fun balance that out. There was a lot of character growth for every character. They all came a long way from the beginning to the end, including Dad Park Ranger, which is really cool. They were able to break a lot of the rules that had been previously established for Power Rangers. And for example, how many episodes of this series ended with cliffhangers that led you to the next episode? This was a little bit more of a serialized show, and I think it happened more in season 2 once it was on Netflix, but it was a lot more serialized than any of the previous seasons ever. And a lot of the other previous seasons were a little bit more episodic until you started getting close to the end. And this season pulled it off for quite a bit, and it worked really well in its favor. So, this show was just great. Plus, the introduction of our first LGBTQ Ranger and watching that relationship flourish was just awesome. However, the season isn't perfect. The Amelia stuff was, it wasn't too subtle. I'm not 100% sure I would have noticed all the clues if I wasn't doing a podcast trying to do a commentary on every episode and watching for those little details. But, it was there. But the part that did throw me off was the RAFCON stuff. Now, not completely. I think the curveball was, see, there was the episode where, what do they call it? Flargon cake or something, or Flargon. And three members of the team liked it. Amelia, Zato, and Ion, and three members didn't like it. Izzy, Javi, and Ollie. And so right there, I was like, that she's got to be from RAFCON, right? But what threw me off was that there was no indication ever that Tarek and Santara were actually from RAFCON also. We just knew that they were aliens. So I think that's what threw everything off. And the fact that he didn't, when Tarek talked about getting the armor and stuff, he just said he found it, which he did. But I don't know. That's what really got me. I thought there was some connection to being RAFCONian, but then when he said he just found the Dino Nightmorpher, I was like, well, maybe he's just some other alien. That would make sense too. So to have them also be RAFCONian made everything obviously fit together really well. But that's the part that had me concerned, because I was like, the rumors had been there since the beginning. Everyone had this thought that they were the parents of Amelia. But then it wasn't fitting because of the alien thing. Anyway, I do have some questions, though. We got a six-month gap at the end there. But first off, all right, so since they helped save the day, I guess the RAFCONians are just welcomed on Earth, okay? We'll let that go. I'm sure, in a better world, in a fictional world, that's possible. But apparently, Ion has come out as alien. So it's okay that he has the antenna and everything. That's different. Of course, there's nothing about that. They just go with the flow. So within the 6 months, he's announced that he's RAFCONian, and he's been welcomed with open arms, apparently. Even able to open a business. However, that last scene, watching them all at Ion's cafe. Jane and Jayborg eat that Flargen cake or whatever. Now, Jayborg, that's weird because she's a robot. She doesn't need to eat. So I can see that she wouldn't have a problem with it. But Jane loved it. So unless Ion changed the recipe some, which is possible, is Jane Rafconian also? I mean, we know nothing about her. It's possible. Who knows? And then another thing. Mucus. Okay, so at the end of the episode, we see this poster of, I don't even remember the names on the poster, Dr. Sly and something. That is obviously Slither in human form, played by Campbell Cooley, who plays him, who does his voice anyway. And Mucus, looking exactly the same as she did during that Wish with Consequences episode. How is she okay with being a human now? Can she switch back and forth and that's why it's okay? I don't know. It seems where she was so against being a human, an ugly human, during that earlier episode. Now she seems to be living her life as human form. It's just kind of weird. One thing I am looking forward to with next season, though, is Javi and Izzy trying to explain to their parents why they've disappeared. Granted, we don't know how this show's going to work. Is this going to be kind of like In Space where they keep coming back to Earth? Or are they going to be in space for the entire season? We don't know. But that's going to be interesting. Especially since Izzy's supposed to be going to college, as we just saw at the finale there. So, yeah. And I got to say, it's kind of nice being able to talk about the finale without having to worry about spoiling anyone. Because if you've gotten this far in the episode, you've seen the final episode at least twice, is my guess. But anyway, so here's what got announced during Hasbro PulseCon 2022 as far as this show is concerned. Well, as far as Cosmic Fury. Dino Fury is over, obviously. Cosmic Fury is the continuation. It's going to pick up right where this episode left off. Somehow we're going to transition Zato into a new suit as well as the rest of the team. How that's going to happen, we don't know yet. The new suits have been revealed, at least for Izzy and Ion. They get new weapons. It looks like they're going to have new morphers. The new suits. They're kind of keeping the helmets. It's still going to be the Dino Fury helmets. There's some new accents to them. These are original, completely original suits for the American production. Not Sentai-based. Really, maybe taking some ideas from Sentai suits. But how can you not after, what are we up to, 46 seasons of Sentai? Things get borrowed. They get new suits, new powers. We're still not sure how that's going to come about. It's only going to be 10 episodes. So if they release that all at once, that if they do like they've done with Dino Fury, they could serialize that all the way through. I mean, that could be like just 2 or 3 days, maybe a week. They could probably use that as an excuse for explaining where they've been to their parents. And everyone keeps referring to this as the MMPR Season 3 method. It's also the Season 2 method, really. Basically, what they're doing is it's all original fight footage for the regular size fights. And when they get into Zords, they're using footage from Q-Ranger. But that's something to look forward to. So, I want to thank you all for listening again. But I'm going to throw it back to Past Me to finish off the episode, and I will talk to you soon. For now, thank you all for listening. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you next time with more Power Ranger greatness. See you later. Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com, or feel free to leave a comment on the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. Ranger Chronicles is now on Patreon. If you'd like to support the show, please visit patreon.com/rangerchronicles for more information. All images and music heard on the show are copyright the respective copyright holders and are used for entertainment purposes only. No infringement is intended. This show is dedicated to everyone, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers since 1993. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thank you, and may the power protect you. Everywhere you look today, weird things are going on. Giant monsters just appear. You pick your eyes, they're gone. We all need a bodyguard to get us through the day.
give God.